All right, well, thank you for joining us this week. This has been a week when the state has been looking at what went wrong in November's election.
Voters in some counties were still in line in the early morning hours on the day after the election. Delays in counting thousands of last-minute absentee ballots once again made Florida the laughingstock of the nation when it couldn't declare a winner until Friday.
The election was decided without them.
A 12-page report details what went wrong. It calls for 14, not 8 days of early voting, with supervisors deciding when and where people early vote.
Franken Memo Cruz.
Here.
Secretary of State Ken Detzner detailed the recommendations before a House committee on Monday.
Voter confidence must be restored.
Lawmakers also share some of the blame because of a lengthy ballot. Time and again, Florida's election supervisors testified that the biggest problem they faced was the length of the ballot, and this wasn't even the longest ballot that voters faced. The report is calling for a shorter ballot summary when lawmakers place constitutional amendments before voters.
To 75 words per constitutional amendment.
The report is getting high marks from the League of Women Voters.
Expanding the number of days of early voting and expanding the number of sites where early voting can take place. Those are both absolutely great recommendations.
In addition to fixing long lines, the League of Women Voters and the ACLU say the state must also make it easier for people to register to vote. In Tallahassee, I'm Mike Vasalinda reporting.
Joining me now, Ken Detzner, the Secretary of State, kind of on the hot seat this week, particularly in the front of the House and Senate committees. Your 12-page report released on Monday suggests three basic changes that need to be made right away. Let's talk about them.
Okay, good. Yeah, first of all, I'd like to point out, Mike, that we had a good election here in Florida, and we had a fair election. But there were some areas, some counties, and some precincts that need improvements on. The governor tasked me to go out and interview those areas, particularly that had problems, and come back with recommendations, and that's what I issued this week. 3 points are expanding locations, having more flexibility in the time, and also the length of the constitutional amendments is an issue that we addressed.
Now, the more in the time area, you're going from back to 14 days is the recommendation, but it's not mandatory as it was before.
No, one thing we heard was that one size does not fit all with counties. Small counties' needs for days and times are different than large counties, so we wanted to build into our recommendation as much flexibility for the independently elected supervisors to exercise their best judgment on what serves their voters.
Right, so a small county, no one would show up 2 weeks out because they just don't have that many voters.
Well, historically, that's what it shows. In fact, the many small supervisors told us that when they were open for the full 14 days, nobody showed up for the first four. So to save cost and taxpayers' money, we need to let them use their best judgment. They are the ones responsible for these elections, and they should know best what serves their voting customer.
And is that also the flexibility of up to 12 or 14 hours a day, depending on how you want?
Exactly. Some of them want to remain open the full period of time, but the key is that flexibility to know what their needs are. And I think giving them that authority and the flexibility is going to go a long way to meeting and solving our problems.
All right, current law was changed in 2011, says you can't do early voting the day the Sunday before an election. This would change that as well.
This would change that, but a court order actually extended that this year and required Dade, Broward, and Palm Beach to stay open. And I can assure you it created a lot of confusion in preparation for Election Day. And we have suggested to the legislature that they may want to consider actually no voting in the office of the supervisor on Election Day because of the confusion it creates in preparation for an election.
And everything else is going on, the calls that are coming in.
Yes, exactly.
All right, now, my recollection and testimony was only about 10 counties had that Sunday before the election anyway, so that would be optional as well.
That's correct. And in fact, this allows for supervisors not only to have the Sunday before the Sunday for election, but also the Sunday before election. In other words, two Sundays, if a supervisor elected, they could be open on both Sundays, before the election and the week before that Sunday as well.
All right. Sorry. And then the idea of expanding the number of early voting locations, it seems in this county there were two that were always very crowded and three that hardly had anybody at them. But in Miami-Dade, there was just all kinds of trouble with early voting locations.
Well, in this county, the definition in current law limits locations to county courthouses and supervisors of elections office and libraries. The definition that we suggest expands it to use civic centers, stadiums, other public facilities like courthouses, and like that go a long way to solving the problem as well.
But you only suggested public facilities, publicly owned facilities. Why?
Well, safety is a big issue. Parking is a big issue. And then when you remember that a facility might need to be available for 14 days, it's very hard for supervisors and can be very expensive for them to try and lease something that's not a government facility. So again, it goes back to serving the voting public. And from the input we received from supervisors, this is what their recommendation generally was. In fact, here in Leon County, Ian Sancho, our supervisor, my supervisor, said, if I could just get the Civic Center at and Fairgrounds, I'd be very happy. It'd be air conditioned, great parking. We wouldn't have any lines at all.
Yeah, and I think about it, you know, a lot of polling places take place in a church, but you certainly couldn't have early voting in a church.
Well, and you couldn't do it in schools. A lot of people suggest we should use schools, but you can't shut schools down to have voting in the gymnasium when children are coming and going and traffic, and you have a large population of people coming in voting. Schools just wouldn't permit it.
Is it a general consensus that the shortened early voting created some of the problems on Election Day?
You know, I'm not really convinced that it is. We still had the same number of hours. 96 hours were still available under the law before the 2000 legislature addressed, and we had 96 hours, created more flexibility. We had record turnouts that we've never had before. So I'm not persuaded that it disenfranchised anyone or that people turned away. I will say that some people perhaps didn't want to wait in line. We're going to solve that problem.
All right, Ken Destner, stay with us. We're going to be right back. We're going to continue our conversation about what went wrong and what's being done to fix it. We'll be right back.